Hey guys, welcome back to Clownfish TV. This is Neon, and it's another day, another daily dose of dismal Disney. Disney mass layoffs signal bleak future for tourist businesses. We're going to talk about some of the numbers here and the massive amount of people that Disney has laid off, and also what this is going to do long term to the Walt Disney Company, because it goes beyond just the theme parks. In fact, some other news outlets are speculating that the MCU is going to be particularly hard hit by the Hollywood shutdown, that Disney can't go for another couple of years with everything staying as is. But the travel industry is going to be catastrophically ravaged by this. Nobody's going to be traveling. I've heard that they're laying off in airports now. They're laying off other hotel chains outside of Disney, other theme parks, obviously. And there's been talk of a second shutdown in the UK. I don't know if that's gone through yet or not, but it's bad. It's really bad. And just because some states are opening things up, it doesn't mean that people are traveling. And usually these sorts of things have long tails too. Look at the recession in 2008. I know I was laid off during the recession, but I didn't get laid off until 2010, like a year and a half after everything had gone to hell in a handbasket. And that's probably what's going to happen with Disney. I think we're going to see that this is just the beginning of the bad news for Disney. I don't think it's the beginning of the end. Disney has been a very resilient company, but they're definitely going to be in a very different place 3 or 4 years from now than they are right now. It's unavoidable. So before we get into it, please subscribe for more pop culture news, views, and rants, guys. We're closing in on 150,000 subs. Thank you for that. Geeky's actually not on this one. She's going to be in some other videos, but she's been kind of back and forth today. So anyway, this is coming from Bloomberg. Now, I'm going to talk about this first, and then we're going to talk about the numbers of the layoffs, which are bad. Talking about, who all got laid off in the 28,000 layoffs coming to Disney. And then we're going to talk about where Disney is. Like, if they think they can, recoup their losses in Hollywood, they can't even do that. And the Guardian's actually speculating that the MCU is going to be particularly hard hit. Well, yeah, because they've got like freaking D-list characters coming. You look at the movies coming out, Eternals and Shang-Chi, and people were joking, they're calling it the MCU. All the characters that anybody cared about, their stories basically ended with Endgame, save for Spider-Man. All the other Avengers, it's over, man. It's over. So Disney mass layoffs signal bleak future for tourist businesses. They're talking about how the travel segment of Disney is doing really bad. And you got to realize, guys, Disney's travel business bankrolls the rest of the company. And now they're down in the movies and they're down in travel. So this woman here, Caitlin Buescher, a 10-year Walt Disney Company employee, had been looking forward to returning to work after maternity leave. Last week was supposed to be her first week back. It didn't turn out that way. She was notified on October 1st that her job was being eliminated, along with 28,000 others at Disney's pandemic-slammed U.S. Resorts and Consumer Products division. Consumer Products, too. You got to realize they rolled, I believe, theme parks and consumer products into one division. It makes it very, very hard to figure out exactly who's pulling their weight and who isn't. But I think Marvel Comics is actually considered part of the consumer products division at this point. I think people understand it's a business decision. It's not personal, she said. Who's looking for another job? Possibly one that isn't travel related. I don't know what's around the corner. They're talking about theme parks are looking like anything but the happiest places on earth these days, in addition to Disney's firing about a quarter of the employees in the U.S. resort business. Other operators, including Comcast, which owns Universal Studios and SeaWorld, have idled or let go thousands of workers recently. That's because attendance by domestic guests has been limited, both by social distancing requirements and the unwillingness of Americans to get on airplanes for family vacations. Or the fact that nobody can afford it. There's that too. International visitors are non-existent because of the travel bans. California Disneyland is still closed. Now, one thing they're not, and I don't know when this was written, but we just went to Orlando like a week ago. And I'm telling you, they're letting as many people into Disney World as they can. I mean, it was very, very crowded. Animal Kingdom and Magic Kingdom were very, very crowded. Too crowded, probably, to be able to do the distancing thing they're supposedly supposed to do. People just aren't ready to come back. They're broke. It's not just the travel industry that's losing money. Everybody's losing money. I mean, pretty much every industry is down. People are broke. And a lot of people that would be traveling are people from states that are in lockdown. They've, you know, probably lost their businesses, lost their jobs. And you're like, well, my God, we can't go see Mickey Mouse this year. I think people have bigger things to worry about. People are not ready to come back, and we're experiencing that in every segment of the industry. Theme parks, water parks, family entertainment centers, says Dennis Spiegel, a theme park consultant in Cincinnati. I didn't even know that was a thing. It's been catastrophic. It has been catastrophic. The pain at the parks mirrors what other businesses dependent on travel and big crowds are experiencing, from casinos in Vegas to your local movie theater. I'm going to talk about that. We've been talking about that. With the virus still a significant risk, a feeling likely reinforced by President Trump's diagnosis, it's possible many tourist-dependent cities will see a second wave of economic damage this year brought by the new rounds of job losses. That's it. You know, these things have long tails. I keep saying it, but like, it's not going to be over. It's not going to be over for a long time. It's going to take years. You can't just like shut the country down for a year almost and expect it to be able to turn everything on like a light switch. It's going to take a ramp up. It's in California. I don't know what the hell's going on in California and New York, but they're not opening up. And that's where a lot of money is, right? Or was. It's going to take 2 to 3 years to fully catch up, and that's not coming back fast. They've already canceled stuff at Disney World, and that's just to catch up. That's just to play catch up. That's just to get to break even point, to undo some of the damage. It might last longer than that. It might take 5 or 6 years for the attendance levels and the revenue to be where it was before the shutdown. After shutting down its parks in March, Disney kept paying its employees. A month later, it shifted to furloughs, meaning employees continued to receive benefits but did not get paid. When summer came and its Florida parks reopened to disappointing traffic, Disney began telling workers many wouldn't be coming back, but the size of the cuts has shocked them nonetheless. I was shocked. I have to tell you, I think Disney's financial state is much worse than they're letting on. They're trying to put a good spin on it. We talked about the other day how they were supposed to have an investor call and they kind of skipped out on it. I think their financial situation is much worse than they're letting on, because they don't want the investors to know, because they're, you know, public company. It's like, oh no, we're fine, guys. Everything's fine. Everything's fine. We sold a whole lot of Mulan. All right. So Anaheim stands to lose more than a third of its 7,800 members in the layoffs, says Chris Dewart. The union has spent the past few months running food banks, handing out boxes of pasta, canned pears, and peanut butter to out-of-work park staffers. It's assisted them in applying for unemployment benefits and has prepared meals for those who've gotten the virus. Negotiations have now begun with Disney over what role seniority will play in determining who gets cut. Discussions also involve the possibility of early retirement for some workers and ongoing healthcare coverage. This is what happened to Geeky's dad when, you know, the airlines took a massive, massive hit right after 9/11. He worked as an airline mechanic, and he was, you know, he basically took early retirement or voluntary layoff because everything was crumbling. You know, they know how many layoffs they're going to have. They just don't know who exactly. And it's a mess because California is not really helping. They're not helping. Newsom's not helping. You know, they basically just Disney's down for the count. And we talked about this earlier in the year when the shutdown first happened, that there were rumors that Disney was actually planning to possibly be shut down for the entire year. And it looks like in California, at least, that is going to be the case. I don't expect the cruise lines to start up again anytime soon. I mean, the cruise lines might be down until the middle of next year. Who the hell knows? You know, it's just basically the tourism has been turned off. And it's times like this, I got to tell you, I am incredibly thankful that we are not depending on theme park blogging, travel blogging as our primary source of income. In fact, we commented about it before. I'm not going to go into a whole lot of details because there's some legal action going on. But to borrow a quote from Zach over at your boy Zach, Comics Matter, He said that he was pushed out of a burning building, meaning that he was in a bad situation and people had pushed him out, meaning the comic book industry, right? He basically got blacklisted from the comic book industry, but he wound up in a much better place. And that's what happened to us, thankfully. And I have to thank all of you for that too, where right before the shutdown, or about 6 months before the shutdown, we were basically pushed out of a theme park travel blog that we'd built. And, you know, we were able to rebound because what we do now is not dependent on travel. And things have actually been going very, very well. So again, just my heartfelt thanks to all of you who watch. It's definitely, you know, kind of saved us anyway. So thank you for that. But it's bad for these guys. And I feel horrible. I feel absolutely terrible for the cast members. You know, we have a lot of friends. They're cast members. Spouses who are cast members, you know, both cast members in Disney and team members in Universal. And we know how bad it is. You know, we know how bad it is. Disneyland layoffs include 1,800 security guards, attraction operators, and Disney characters. You're not going to see as many Disney characters. Disney notified Teamsters, Local 495, and the Independent Employees Service Association, that's Disneyland, and Disney California Adventure employees will absorb more than 1,800 of the 28,000 layoffs coming to the parks, entertainment, and products division. Okay, so this is important. Disney Parks, entertainment, and products division. Again, last time I checked, and they keep restructuring things, but I believe companies like Marvel Comics are actually part of that division too. So it'll be interesting to see what happens. So they're letting the security guards go. And in Florida, more than 8,800 part-time Disney cast members are among those laid off, said the union. So they are laying off union members. Service Trades Council, Union, STCU, statement on Disney negotiations and agreement. Now, the cynic in me says that Disney is going to use this opportunity to, I guess, bust up the union. I don't know. I know that they weren't real keen on the terms of the union. Last year, the year before, they signed some agreement. I think it was both in California and in Florida that they're going to raise the minimum wage for workers, et cetera, et cetera. And I would not be surprised if they use this as an excuse to renege on that. I think Kickstarter did this too, because we saw they got rid of Camilla Zhang, who was, you know, one of the ones pushing the hardest for the union at Kickstarter. They got rid of her, but now it looks like they're hiring another comic book outreach person / gatekeeper, right? So I think that they might use the opportunity now to, we saw they're getting rid of a bunch of entertainers. You know, a lot of people have been there for a long time, like Yeehaw Bob Jackson and all that. And yeah, I mean, Disney is never gonna be the same after this. They will never be the same after this. It's going to take years and years for them to recoup. Again, we're not saying Disney is going to go out of business. Not at all. Disney has survived. You know, they're kind of like cockroaches, I guess. They have survived through some pretty catastrophic events, but, you know, they're getting cut off in the theaters. They're getting cut off in the theme parks. I thought this was interesting, this article on The Guardian, talking about, you know, Marvel in particular is going to be in a bad place after the pandemic. Marvel, though, looks to be in an especially precarious position. Not only are its films too costly to be diverted to a streaming service, but they're too intricately scheduled with launch dates fixed years in advance to be released out of their pre-planned chronological order. After all, the MCU has staked its brand on overlapping characters and interconnected storylines intended to be watched in sequence. The delay to Black Widow, not to mention the effects of production shutdowns, will surely create a domino effect on future titles. The studio also faces a balancing act between stoking fans' anticipation and allowing titles such as Black Widow to gather cobwebs on the shelf. They talk about Shang-Chi and the Eternals coming in 2021. They're getting pushed back, apparently. Thor Love and Thunder was supposed to be 2022. Would not surprise me if it got pushed back, and Doctor Strange too. The volatility of the current situation means that the blockbuster stranglehold might at least be loosened for a time. In the short term, independent films have allowed more of a look in. That's the thing. They've sort of painted themselves into a corner. One, they've gotten rid of all the characters anybody really gives a shit about. And two, they've already, you know, locked in a certain sequence they have to release these movies in. And then three, if they take a break for like 2 years in Marvel movies, is anybody going to care? I mean, are they? I mean, Endgame, for a lot of people, Endgame was the end of the MCU. I think a lot of people are still looking forward to what Sony's going to do with Spider-Man. But I think that the momentum has been lost. And that's basically what's going to happen. You know, I mean, I guess it's better than having a freaking blockbuster. It had to go see every 3 months, you know. But from Disney's point of view, it's like Star Wars is kind of dead in the water. Marvel's kind of dead in the water. And Disney is not going to be in a very good place when this is all said and done. I think they're going to actually probably come out in some of the worst shape of the major studios. Granted, they have Disney Plus, but you gotta realize, guys, they're still in the hole for Disney Plus. No matter how many subs they have, it's gonna take, like, they already projected before the pandemic, it was gonna take like 5 or 6 years for Disney Plus to actually turn a profit. And now they can't really afford to invest in shows like they were before. So it's a mess. It is a mess. It is definitely dismal Disney news. And again, thoughts and prayers go out to those of you who were affected by the layoffs. Hopefully everybody can rebound as quickly as possible. I would strongly recommend that you find a job outside of the travel industry, and one that doesn't necessarily depend on having groups, large groups of people, just to kind of future-proof your job, maybe get an office job someplace or something. I don't know, guys. I'll talk to you later.